I had legitimacy because my family has deep roots here. Mm-hmm. That gave me some legitimacy, and they sort of did a massive article mm-hmm. in the paper that was published in two issues of the paper, sort of mm-hmm. introducing me into the community. But they weren't really sure what I was going to do here, because many had come and left. They tried different businesses. And I was just really spiritually led, brother, mm-hmm. spiritually led, because the ancestors are not resting in peace in their graveyards. And I spent a lot of time in the graveyards doing the research, you know, going into people's homes, going into the churches, listening. This river, there are rumors of just, you know, murder and people disappearing and unsolved cold cases. And I decided to build the Newberry Foundation and really get serious about bringing resources and education and images. You don't find any African American images, any African American plaques, any African American markers anywhere in Pulaski County. Right, right. And there's a rich history of African Americans in this part of Georgia. Right, right. So we're here, right. but we're nowhere. Right. And a lot of the history has been erased right. and the memories are fading. Right. And what we're doing is we're resurrecting the dead, because they are not resting in peace, brother. And there's a lot of things that have happened here that have been illegal. Mm-hmm. People's land have been stolen. Birth rights have been denied. Mm-hmm. People given unfair sentences in that courthouse, which is soaked in blood and tears. Mm-hmm. People have gotten away with rape, mm-hmm. murder, pillage, plundering. You just, I mean, just do whatever you want.
Right. Right.
You know, and so this community has been traumatized, terrorized, yeah. pacified
yeah.
for years. So there's a lot of fear when you are here and you're talking about politics and voting rights. And people politicians used to buy votes with liquor, and there are all sorts of stories of voter suppression here. You know, voter intimidation, people purchasing votes, people not really understanding how to register, right. how to vote, who they voted for, or what their government is supposed to do for them. So you're entering into a spooky, mystic, mysterious place where people have been severely traumatized over the generations, but at the same time, in the pacification of these people, they've been given pseudo sort of resources, mm-hmm. and there's a kind interchange between the races, mm-hmm. but it's all pseudo and superficial, because underneath that, it's extremely segregated. Right. And black people have always been taught to stay in their place, and blacks that are from here, over 50, many of them won't come back here. And when they come back here, they tell stories of what their lives were like, and they can't believe we're here on Commerce Street. This is unheard of. Right. People ask me all the time, are you afraid? Because the fear of being an independent, self-determined black person in Hawkinsville was a death sentence, and they understood that.
Let me ask, have you ever been to jail?
Data, campaigning, voting rights to prevent right. voting suppression,
right, right, right.
canvassing, poll watching. This is a multi-state effort right here. And you being here right now is divine, brother. With your experience, this is it. So look, quickly. So it's culture, democracy, history, and music, brother. So we have information. You know, where people can get registered to vote. Here's African Studies, brother. African Studies. Right there. This is your baby right here. It's all Africa right here. All Africa right here. So you've got information that can empower the mind, strengthen the heart, you know. Murals over here. You know, we have this display on democracy and preventing voting suppression. The work that President Obama was involved in. This is a brochure when I ran for state senate here in District 20, we got over 35,000 votes. Just fascinating over here.
I just can't even believe.
We have a collection of a complete set of Dr. Carter G. Woodson's Journal of Negro History. We have one of three of the only sets of the official records of the Civil War, 188 volumes. The official records right here, priceless collection. Here we have a collection of Jet Magazine. Jet magazines from the 1950s through today. Here's one, 1963, Should Negro Stars Join the Freedom Fight? So we've been dealing with this effort of preventing voting suppression for a long time. So welcome to the Plow and Pew Democracy Center. We have events here, training to empower the citizens to vote and be a part of shaping the democracy in the United States of America. Up here we have some of the heroes and some of the sheroes, from Maya Angelou to Dr. Henry Clark, A. Philip Randolph, Mugabe, Madam C.J. Walker, the great Stephen Biko, the great Mr. John Johnson. You know we love our brother Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Booker T. Washington. And here we have Fannie Lou Hamer, the famous poet and writer, Richard Wright. Of course, the great Paul Robeson and Julian Bond. In my hand, for example, in addition to our extraordinary African American legends, I have an original copy of the Journal of Negro History. This is volume one, published in 1916. We have the complete collection of Dr. Carter G. Woodson's journal, which supports the work of the Democracy Center. In addition to that, we have our African Studies journals. We have information from around the world that speaks to the hearts and the minds of those visitors that come into the Democracy Center. So we're multi-purpose. We talk about democracy, we talk about history, we talk about good governance, we talk about civic education, and we do that in a safe space where there are comfortable seats, and the beneficiaries that come in are reflected in the images. You see the late Marcus Garvey, you see the late Patrice Lumumba, you see the former president of Egypt, Anwar Sadat, of course, the great Rosa Parks. On top of that, we have the largest collection of piano rolls here, certainly in the state of Georgia. These are piano rolls that go back to the days of Scott Joplin. We're talking the 1890s. We're talking the early 1900s. Some of the classic piano rolls that we allow beneficiaries to come in. And on some of our pianos, for example, this one here, and you can actually hear them once we put them inside of the piano, and they can hear the wonderful music from that golden era that Scott Joplin is well known. So we're combining history, music, culture, and democracy all in one space. This section right here is our women's studies section. We have the great writers of Alice Walker and Toni Morrison, Angela Davis, and so many other great women writers like Sonia Sanchez and Gwendolyn Brooks and others. But also, we have cultural artifacts like this altar that we were able to salvage from the primitive Baptist church that was in existence from the mid-1800s. Unfortunately, the church burned down, but we were able to salvage this altar, restore it, and we use it during our functions and receptions. This table here, built in 1905, one piece,
of pine wood, the transactions that took place across this table certainly reflect a time of great commerce for African Americans here in Pulaski County. Finally, we would not be able to do the work if it were not for the support of the Center for Common Ground. We want to thank Andrea Miller, her board of directors, and all her supporters that believed in her vision of creating democracy centers, partnering with local organizations like ours that had credibility in the community. We know the community. We had infrastructure in place. And with her training, her technical assistance, her software that gives us access to voter trends and voter behavior, we're able to target particular voters to ensure that they get to the polls and they vote in their best interest. Democracy is power. Democracy is life. We are committed to being a part of this incredible movement that's sweeping America to stop the takeover ever again in our nation's capital. And we do that by providing civic education, by strengthening the capacity of local organizations that's committed to eradicating voter suppression. So Center for Common Ground, we thank you. We look forward to being a part of the future of democracy in America. Please visit us at thenewberryfoundation.org. We're located at 89 Commerce Street in Hawkinsville, Georgia. And don't hesitate to be a part of this critical and important work. Our address is P.O. Box 1112, Hawkinsville, Georgia, 31036. That's P.O. Box 1112, Hawkinsville, Georgia, 31036. And the telephone number is 202-454. That's 202-455-9284. Thank you. I'm your friend, Dr. Julius Johnson.
Wake up, everybody. No more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking. Time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war, and poverty. Oh, wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. If we just let it be, na 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 na, the world won't get no better. We gotta change it now, just you and me.